Alastair, what are the first symptoms someone with Parkinson's might experience?
It can be very varied, actually. So Parkinson's is a condition of the brain that presents in many different fashions and affects people in very different ways. People may first notice a tremor or slowing down or difficulty with dexterity. Those are the kind of motor symptoms of Parkinson's. But actually, when we ask people, when they come to clinic for the first time with Parkinson's, what happened first, we actually find out there are other things like loss of sense of smell, vivid dreams or act out their dreams, long-standing constipation or urinary problems or anxiety or depression. So there's really quite a broad range of symptoms that people can have as the initial symptoms of Parkinson's.
When I was diagnosed, I assumed there was just one type of Parkinson's as well. And of course, there's so many different types of Parkinson's and everyone experiences Parkinson's differently. And for those with young onset, you really don't expect your condition to be Parkinson's. So for me, it was shuffling. So I like going on long walks, and my husband noticed that I was shuffling my foot or dragging my left foot slightly. But we just thought, he was like, you need to go and see the chiropractor again, because your back's obviously not aligned properly, because I'd had a few back issues in the past. So we just assumed it was down to that. And then following on from that, it was a lack of an arm swing on my left side. So yeah, that's when I did the whole, you know, Google, why is my left arm, which brought me to Parkinson's. Now, luckily for me, I've got some understanding of Parkinson's because my mother had it. So I was able to go, okay, that could be a real possibility. Whereas for others, particularly those, you know, in the younger age bracket, I think they it probably can take a long time to be diagnosed.
I think that's true. And I think the other thing to say, and it sounds like it was your experience too, the signs and symptoms are not always there. They may only emerge after a long walk or, you know, a period of doing physical activity. We recognize that tremor, for example, often comes and goes in the early stages. It's not always going to be there when you look for it. So, but then things, you know, obviously become clearer over time. It may not always be the first thing they think of. It may not be the first thing that their doctor thinks of either.
Yeah. Are there certain symptoms that are more likely to trigger someone, do you think, to go and see a doctor than others?
There are a few ways to answer that question. I mean, the perceived symptom severity that someone has would trigger them to see a doctor. So if they had a new tremor, for example, I think lots of people would go and see their general practitioner at that point. Yeah. Whereas if people had, you know, constipation, they may not see their GP for a period of time. There may be some variability in whether general practitioners recognize that this may be a presenting feature of Parkinson's and then refer them on to secondary care where the diagnosis is normally made. So we just completed a piece of work looking in primary care records in East London, and actually people see their GP with a whole host of things in the decade before they get a diagnosis of Parkinson's. Interestingly, even people with tremor can see their GPs for 10 years before they get an eventual diagnosis. So, and one would say when there's a tremor, there's an opportunity to make a diagnosis fairly promptly. So there are many reasons why I think the diagnosis gets delayed.
If someone is gone to see their GP, what's generally the next step?
Assuming that the GP thinks of or suspects Parkinson's at that point, then what the NICE clinical guidelines tell us is that the person in question should be referred to a specialist clinic that has expertise in making that diagnosis, not just the diagnosis of Parkinson's, but also considering the differential diagnosis, the alternative explanation. So that would typically be a neurology clinic. It may be a movement disorders clinic, or it may be for older patients, a care of the elderly clinic, but it should be somewhere that has experience and expertise in making the diagnosis and then also managing patients from that point forwards.
For me, I saw a neurologist, and there are just general tests that I think your GP and your neurologist get you to do, such as walking, and then you do something called the pinch test. You can see on that hand I'm doing that fine, whereas this hand, you know, it is much slower. So it's little things like that. After I saw the neurologist, I then went on to have a DAT scan, which is a brain scan to look at your dopamine levels. I wouldn't want anyone to be afraid of that DAT scan. For me as a mother, with three kids, they put lovely bird music on and I found it a relaxing half an hour. So it doesn't need to be horrific. If anyone watching thinks that they may have Parkinson's disease symptoms, do check out our videos, particularly our one on What is Parkinson's for a simple and easy to follow explanation.